So, how do you visualize your findings using NVivo? So, in this presentation, I'm going to show you step by step how to visualize your findings. One of the ways is to develop project map. You can develop work cloud. You can also develop a framework matrix and other visual representation that will be helpful for you to tell your stories. So sometimes when you are presenting the themes, you may have to also have visual representation to help your audience to better understand your findings. So having a tool that will help you to develop a visual representation is very helpful. And NVivo can also is going to be a very good tool for you if you want to try to develop visual representation. So let me show you how to do it. So as you can see here, I have all my themes here under the first research question and also themes under the second research question. So the first thing I want to do is, let's say you are presenting your findings and you are presenting one of the themes and you want to show the participant that are connected to a specific theme. If you want to show the participant that are connected to that theme, so what do you have to do? There's a function here called map that you could use. If when you go to explore, you can develop a project map when you go to explore and click on map and click on project map. When you have it here, you have to give it any name. So I would say theme for research question one. You can give a description, but it's not required. You click on OK. So what you're going to do is that you're going to focus on the theme that you are interested in. So let's say I'm interested in the first theme, being new to the profession. So what you could do is the first option that you could do is to drag and drop the theme here. The first option is drag and drop. Another option that you could do is right click here, go to add project, and then click on quote, click on the plus sign here, and look for the theme that you want to bring into the map. You check this one, the one that you want to bring to the map, and click on OK. So you have that information here. You right click on it again and select show associated items. And then you can see that there are options here that are connected to this theme, right? What we are looking for, we want to find out the participants that are connected to this theme. So you go to the cases, right? And it looks like two participants are connected to this theme. So you can drag and drop, or you can double click, and then the two cases will be shown here, right? So these are the two participants connected. But we also want to know who are these participants, right? What are their demographics? So you right click here, you go to show associated items. In this case, you go to attribute value. So the attribute values is just like demographic characteristics, right? So you click on that and you go here and you can double click the age. You go to the gender, you double click. You go to the experience, you double click the number under the experience. You go here, double click. You do the same thing for the second participant. You right click here, show associated item. Go to attribute values. As I said, attribute values are the values associated with the variables. So you can see here, 33, 2 years of experience, and the person is African American. So as you can, let me pull this one a little bit here so that you can see what I'm doing here. So as you can see here, there's a diagram. It doesn't look pretty. So what you have to do is go to layout and then click on any of the options here so that you can see. And you just want to see whether it can rearrange it nicely for you. There's another option here. I like this option. Let me pull this so that I can see. So you can see that this is the theme and this is the cases for each participant. And then the demographic information. So imagine that you are presenting this theme, right? And explaining it. You can show this diagram to show who are connected to this theme and also the background of participant. So this is going to be a very useful information when you want to show people who are the participants that are connected to this theme. Let's try the second one. Let's say we want to choose another theme from here. I think we can choose this one. So when you finish, you can close it. So let's do a second one. We go to explore, we go to maps, we go to project map, and then theme for research question two, and then click on OK. As I said, there are two options here. You can drag and drop it here. So we can do that. Let me drag and drop it here. Right click on this one, you go to associated items. The first step is to look for the participant. Where are you going to get the participant cases? There are two participants here connected to this theme. And then you right click on one of the participant case and show associated items. What you are looking for is the characteristics. So the attributes, values, that's what you are looking for. You double click for the age, gender, years of experience, ethnicity. You do the same thing for the second one. Go to associated items, age, work experience, African American. And then if you want to arrange it nicely, you can choose anyone here that makes sense or makes it presentable. If you want to export, you can right-click on it and click on export so that you'll be able to save it in JPEG file and you'll be able to show in your presentation. So that's how you want to do it. If you close this one and want to look for that information, you can go to visualizations and then click on maps and to show all the one that you have already created. So you can double-click on it and see the map that we have created. So this is how you can generate project map. The next thing that we could do is the work cloud. We go to explore and then you can click on word frequency and then you can go to selected items and then you select what you want. The word frequency is showing the kinds of words participants use and how many times, right? So you can use their transcript to see the kinds of words. You can choose the one that you are interested in. You can also look at the containers, right? The themes that they have. And then you'll be able to see the kind of words that they use. It's going to run the significant information that has been connected to this theme, right? So any significant information you have dropped into this theme, you can run a word frequency query on that. So you can click on here and click on word frequency. Okay, so this one is showing no results. The reason being that it's just telling you that there's not enough items in the codes or in the themes for you to run the word frequency. So in this case, we will not focus on the themes. We'll focus on the transcript. So we click on all the transcript and then here you can maintain it what it is or you can bring it in the middle depending on what you want to find. Normally, I just leave this one alone. I just want to see the exact words that they use and how many times. When you bring it down, it will cluster the words based on the meaning. As I said, it depends on you. I just click on run query, and then you can see here that burnout was repeated 22 times. Work was repeated 17 times. If you want to see the work cloud, you click on this one, and you can see the work cloud here. It would take a few seconds for it to show, about maybe 10 seconds. Okay, so we have the word cloud here. You have options to change it to the colors that you want or the arrangement of the words how you want it. So you can explore these and choose the one that you like. So you can see here that burnout was mentioned many times. Work was also mentioned a lot of times. So the bigger the font, the higher the number of times it was mentioned. If you want to stop any word from showing here, you can right-click on that word. Let's assume that we don't want to see burnout in this visual representation. You can right-click on that and then click on Add to Stop Word and then click on OK and then run it again. And then the system will take out the burnout. So you'll not see the banner, you'll see other words here, right? If this visual representation doesn't make sense to you, you shouldn't present it in your findings, right? Because this one It's just adding more explanation to what you are going to present in terms of your theme. So you don't have to have it if it's not adding good information or making your audience understand the themes that you are presenting. If you want to export, you right click here and click on export word cloud, and you'll be able to export that information. Another thing that you can do is, let's assume that you are interested in knowing the kinds of words participants use before and after stress. So you can right click on it and then click on run test search query for stress. As you can see here, when you click on word tree, it will show you the words before and after stress. This one, it can be a very good presentation if, let's say, you are talking about stress as one of the burnout causes. You can show this information. As you can see here, you can increase the number of words before and after, and you can reduce it, and you can export that information here. You can right click and export. If you want to see the source of this document, you double click on stress and it will take you to where that information is. So you see where stress was mentioned, right? When I double click on that. The same way here, when you want to see the source of experience or any other word, you right click and you open this one and it takes you to the place, the source of the information. So it takes you to where the information was captured. And then if you want to know where exactly in each of the documents, you click on the file and you see it will take you to that place. So that's how, you know, this one can be useful. If you want to dig into what you found, you can always right click and see the options and then explore. So that's all about the word cloud. There's another way of doing the word search. You click on explore, you go to test search, right? And then you search for the word. So let's say I'm looking for experience, right? I want to know how the experience was used. You can bring it down or leave it alone here if you want an exact match, and click on query. So, and then you click on word tree and it will show you words before and after experience. If you want to know the source of that, you go to reference and it will show you where that information is coming from. So that's how you can do word search and search for words and then look for the location and all the source, right? So that's all about the word search and the word cloud. The next one that I want to share with you is framework Mattress. The Mattress is just giving you a table that has all the themes or the themes that you have selected and the source of that information. And it will have in a table form. And within the cell in the table, you will see the significant information that is connected to both the theme and also the source or the participant. I'm going to show you. So if you are not clear, I think after showing you, you'll be able to know what I'm talking about. So if you go to create and you go to framework Mattress, you'll give it a name. So I would just say project for now. And then you go to roles and then you select what you want to be in the role of the table. I will select all the participants, right? And then click on OK. And then I go to column. What do you want to be in the column? So you select here. For the research question one, I want to see all the themes in the column. Each column will have one theme. And then you click on OK and then click on OK here. And the system will create a table for you that will be very useful for you, especially when you are about to write your findings, right? You can look at this table, you know the themes and you know the significant information connected to the theme that you have. So this is the framework Mattress. If you want to see everything, you right click here and go to undock. So it will pull the table so that you see everything. You can see that for the P1 transcript, these are the information that was extracted from that and is connected to this theme. And this information is connected to that theme, right? So you see all the themes are in the column and then the roles will be participants. So imagine you are writing about this theme, right? If you want to quote participants, you copy and then indicate the participant that information is connected to. So this one is very useful when you are presenting your findings. If you want to export, you just right click here and export that, and it will be in Excel spreadsheet for you to look at it. Sometimes when you do this table, the information here might not populate, it might not show. So what you have to do is that you go to click on framework metrics here and click on auto summarize, and that will help pull up all the information that was coded from each of the transcripts. And this is what you're going to see, right? So in case you want to make sure that everything has been pulled from the system, you just click on auto summarize, right? So that's what I have for you for this one. As I said, the use of this one is helping you to write your finding. And you can also put this one as an appendix so that if people want to see the kind of information that was extracted from each of the participants, you can also show this information. Another one that I want to show you is the Mattress. So you go to explore and click on Mattress coding query. And this one gives an explanation. We don't have to read that. So you leave it alone, close it. So when you look at this one, what you have to think about is you click on this plus sign, click on items, right? So this one, you can choose the transcript here, right? Any one of them that you think that you want to look into, right? You can choose all of them or choose some of them. And then you can click on OK. And then you can click on plus sign here and click on select items. And in this case, let's say you want to look into some themes and how they are connected to participants. So you click on this, you click on codes and then plus sign. Let's look at the themes connected to question one. So I check maybe three of them and click on OK. And then when you finish, you click on run query. So this one will give you a table, a matrix. And then you see all the participants will be in column, the first column. You can see that each row will be participant information. The second column to the third column will be the themes. And in this, each cell will show the number of significant information connected to both the participant and also the theme. So here you can see zero. This means that there wasn't any information that was extracted from participant P1 that is related to the first theme. But the second theme, there are two information there. And then you can double click on that and it'll take you to the source of the two information. You see here, this is from the participant P1, the two information there. So in case you want to know the kind of information that connects the two items, which is the participant and also the theme, you can always double click the cell. One interesting visual representation that you could do is to click on chat. So this chat will show participants and also the themes and the number of counts or the code counts, right? The number of times significant information will drop into that theme. So this one is four. You can export this one, but when you export, you cannot move it as I move it here, right? If you really want to move it like this one, maybe when you're doing your presentation, you have to show this place and then move it for people to see. But if you want to export, you can just right click and export the chat. Or you can also show this metrics for people to see the themes that are connected to a specific participant for concerning the research question one. Another option is you can export this table to Excel and then you can create your own chat from that. So there's a lot of options for you. When you right click here, you see transpose, right? So this means that you can make the columns to be rows and the rows to be columns. So if you click on that, you can see that P1 is now here and that the themes are here, right? Also, the chat will change a little bit, right? As you can see here. So there are a lot of options for you. You just have to think about which one makes sense. So this is what I have for you. This is what you need for you to start writing your findings. And I have a presentation on how to, you know, present your findings when you check on one of my YouTube videos. And I hope that this one was really helpful for you. If you have any questions, please leave it in the comment section. I'll be happy to respond to you. And if you want one-on-one consultation, please contact me. My email address is info@drphilipedu.com. Thank you for your time.